Hello friends, we discussed design of rigid pavements in another video. Here we are discussing design of double bars and tie bars in a concrete pavement. Double bars are smooth round bars which mainly serve as load transfer device in a concrete pavement. The tie bars are deformed rebars or connectors which are used for holding faces of rigid slabs in contact to maintain aggregate interlock. We should remember that tie bars are not load transferring devices, and tie bars are used in longitudinal joints whereas double bars are used in transverse joints in a concrete pavement. Now this shows the difference between a tie bar and a double bar. If this is the direction of movement of traffic, then tie bars are used in joining the slabs in longitudinal directions, whereas double bars are used in transverse direction to transfer the wheel load from one slab to another slab. Load transfer at transverse joints is done through double bars. Double bars are generally made of mild steel, and maximum bearing stress between concrete and double bar is obtained from this equation, where this FB max is the maximum bearing stress, KMDS is modulus of double support, PI is the load transferred by double bar, and this beta is relative stiffness of the bar embedded in the concrete, whereas Z is the joint spacing. E is the modulus of elasticity of double bar, and I is the moment of inertia. Beta in this equation is given by this equation, 4th root of KMDS BD upon 4EI, where this KMDS, I told you, it is modulus of double support. Its value is suggested as 415,000 MPa per meter in IRC 58. Each double bar should be designed for the maximum load being transferred by it for the allowable bearing pressure, and allowable bearing pressure in the concrete is determined by this equation, where FB is allowable bearing stress, FCK is characteristic compressive strength of concrete in MPa, and BD is the diameter of double bar. And therefore, the design reduces to maintaining this FBX less than or equal to FB. The recommended dimensions of double bars in IRC code, depending upon the slab thickness, are given in this table, and you can choose the diameter, length and spacing of double bars based on the thickness of the slab. Important consideration in the design of double bars is the group action. When loads are applied at a joint, a portion of the load is transferred to the other side of the slab through double bars. If the load is near the joint of a pavement tied to a concrete solder, a part of the load is transferred to solder also. The double bar immediately below the wheel load will carry maximum amount of load, and other double bars transfer progressively smaller magnitude of the load. Now here, the radius of relative stiffness is important, and the double bars within distance of one radius of relative stiffness, that is 1L, from the point of load application participate in load transfer. And if you assume a linear variation of the load carried by different double bars within 1 by L, the maximum load carried by a double bar can be computed. This point I will explain in detail when we go for the actual design example. Tie bars are used for longitudinal joints, and area of steel required per meter length of joint can be estimated from this equation, where B, lane width, is only 3.5 meter, F, coefficient of friction between pavement and the sub-base, 1.5, W is the weight of slab in kilonewton per meter cube, and HT is allowable working stress of steel in MPa. The length of tie bar should be at least twice that required to develop a bond strength equal to the working stress of the steel. And therefore, this is given by this equation, twice of SST ACS B star into P PTP. And all these variables are explained here. ST, the allowable working stress in steel, ACS, cross-sectional area of one tie bar, millimeter square, PTB is parameter of the tie bar, and B star is permissible bond stress of concrete, which is taken as 1.75 MPa for plain tie bars and 2.46 MPa for deformed tie bars. Now, details of tie bar as given in IRC 58, depending upon again the slab thickness, you can choose diameter from this column, and the maximum spacing for plain or deformed bar and minimum length required for plain or deformed bar. Now, let us take one example on design of dowel bars and tie bars. Let us assume these are the design parameters. Slab thickness is 300 mm, joint width to 20 mm, which is typical. Modulus of grade reaction K 200 MPa per meter. Modulus of dowel support KMDS 415,000 MPa per meter. E for dowel bar 2 into 10 power 5 MPa, and V load is 50 kN. And we assume certain parameters from the table. The diameter of dowel bar is taken as 38 mm. Spacing between dowel bar 300 mm. This is taken from the table given in IRC 58. And for 100% joint efficiency, we assume load transfer to 50%. So the total load to be transferred is 25 kN. Radius of relative stiffness can be calculated using this equation, L E H cube 12 1 minus mu square into K. E is 3 into 10 power 6, H 30 centimeter, 12 into 1 minus mu into K 200 MPa per meter, and this value comes out to be 766.5 millimeter. So that is the value of L. We take length of dowel bar 500 millimeter and characteristic strength of concrete 40 MPa for M40 concrete, and E for concrete is 3 into 10 power 6. So this value we have used here also. Now with these parameters, we find out permissible bearing stress in concrete using this equation. Now BD is 38, the diameter of the dowel bar, FCK 40, and that gives you 26.7 MPa. This is the permissible bearing stress. Now, as I told you, the first dowel bar is placed at a distance of 150 mm from the pavement edge, and dowel bars up to a distance of L from the point of load application are effective in load transfer. Thus, you can find out how many dowel bars will participate in load transfer by using this equation, 1 plus L upon spacing between dowel bars. 1 plus 766.5 is the value of L, 300 is the spacing we assumed, and that gives you 3 dowel bars. So 3 dowel bar will participate. If PT is the total load transferred by the first dowel bar, then the total load transferred by the dowel bar system, or you can say group of dowel bars, will be 1 plus L minus 300 upon L plus L minus 600, that is the second dowel bar, upon L into PT. And this gives you the total load transfer is 1.825 PT. Now this total load transfer should be equal to the total load to be transferred, and that is 25 kN, assuming 100% efficiency of the joint. Therefore, if you put 1.825 into PT equal to 25, you get PT 13.69 kN. Now with this load, let us check for the bearing stress. The moment of inertia of dowel bar, pi upon 64 into BD to the power 4, that is 102 millimeter to the power 4, and relative stiffness of dowel bar embedded in the concrete is given by this equation beta, and here all these parameters you can see from the design parameters given in the question, and you put all these values here, you get beta 0.021 millimeter minus 1. Now with these values you can calculate what is the maximum bearing stress between concrete and dowel bar using this equation. Now all parameters are known here, beta we calculated 0.021, pt we calculated 13.69 kilonewton, beta is again. Now KMDS is 415,000 MPa and Z is the joint width 20 millimeter, E is the modulus of double bar, that is 2×10⁵ MPa, I is the moment of inertia of double bar, that is calculated 102,302 mm⁴, and therefore you substitute all these values in this equation, you get FB max is 18.13 MPa, which is less than the permissible stress, that is 26.7 MPa, and therefore the design is safe. Now we come to the design of tie bars. Let us select the diameter of tie bar 12 millimeter, and area required per meter length of the joint would be given by this equation, and therefore if you take B lane width 3.5 meter, F coefficient of friction between pavement and subbase as 1.5, the weight of slab 24 kilonewton per meter cube, and HT allowable working stress of steel, which is 125 MPa as per IRC code, and that gives you AS is equal to 302.4 millimeter square per meter. The cross-sectional area of tie bar pi by 4 d square 113 millimeter square, perimeter pi d 37.7 millimeter, and spacing of tie bar is given by this equation. A is 113 millimeter square per meter, and therefore this is the balancing factor 1000 to convert meter into millimeter, and AS is 302.4 and it gives you 373.7 millimeter. So let us provide a spacing of 370 millimeter, that is maximum for plain tie bar. Length of tie bar can be calculated using this equation, 2×SST ACS upon B into PTPB. Now we know all parameters. Therefore, you substitute SST 125, AST 113, P, PTB 37.7 millimeter, beta star is permissible bond stress of concrete, that is 1.7 MPa for plain tie bar, and therefore you get value of L 428.2 millimeter. Now to this value we add 100 millimeter for loss of bond due to painting and another 50 millimeter for tolerance in placement of tie bar, and therefore we provide a length of tie bar as 580 millimeter. So if you summarize the design, it is like this: the diameter of dowel bars 38 millimeter, spacing between dowels 25 centimeter, length of dowel bar 50 centimeter, joint width 2 centimeter, spacing between contraction joints is 4.5 meter and longitudinal joint 3.5 meter. And in case of tie bar, diameter of tie bar is 12 millimeter, length of tie bar in case of plain tie bar it is 580 millimeter, which we calculated. If you carry out the same calculations for deformed bar, it will be 640 millimeter, and similarly spacing between tie bar for plain bars will be 370 millimeter, and for deformed bar it will be 540 millimeter. So that is how the dowel bars and tie bars are designed in a concrete pavement. Thanks for watching, and you can write your comments in the comment box.